Hey guys, it's your boy Curve Bears, and welcome back to my Liverpool Hookerama, where the last time I thought I started season 2 with wins over Bayern in the Super Cup, the UEFA Super Cup, or whatever it's called now. I think it's still called the Super Cup, I'm not too sure about that. And, of course, picking up the win at the start of this season in important 3 points against Watford. In this, so I have the Black Cats of Southampton and the Canaries. He's Norwich. Norwich is actually going to be my first home game of the season after her visits to Vicarage Road in the last episode, and now the Stadium of Light. On this match, which is going to have an extra factor to it, the heavy rain that's been I know I must keep an eye on Jermaine Lenz, who's up there somewhere, probably over there at the wing in position. Oh, there he is, he's already on the ball. He scored 2 goals in Sunderland's first match, so we'll be looking to keep him quiet for today. Of course, I'll say, you know, you don't have my own embrace hero of the first game. And Correa scored a brace in the first game. And Sturridge and Bale have both scored in that match as well. So, there is Bale against the Red and White of Sunderland. Nathaniel Clyne! He's hit it straight at Moroney. And it's not giving him much of a problem. And here is Bale. All again. And yeah, outpace Lenz in. Yeah, the weak place. Come back! Penalty! He lands with a terrible mistake. The man I said might be Sunderland's biggest goal threat. It has given me a goal scoring opportunity. He threw Marco Reus. Buries it. At the German opens the scoring. It's 1-0. What is going through Lenz's mind at the moment? First goal of the season for Marco Reus. And it's 1-0. And all Lenz can do is think, why did he make such a clumsy challenge? I mean, you know. Well, yes. I mean, you can't exactly just let it. You just can't let Bale run at your goal because he has a goal threat and, you know, two strikers poaching around and Roy. He's in Coutinho as well. Also, you can't exactly give any of my players as much sight of goal or he will easily punish. Kind of error. Here's Rodriguez. Klein. From left to right to Reus. Oops. Plays it back to former Sunderland man Jordan Henderson, and he blows the sky high. Hey, wait, why is it showing Rodwell? Did it take a deflection? Oh, it did. I don't think it would have mattered. I don't think it was exactly going in. Maybe it was. Maybe Moroni would have been forced into a save. Had it not taken that deflection off of Jack Rodwell. Here's Correa. Against Matthews. Plays it back to Henderson again. Not going to take the shot because I saw Rodwell was there again. It's coming back to Henderson. Oh, why did I slide? Why did he slide in? All he had to do was poke that home and that's 2-0. He scored against his former club. But he slid in. He's doing a bit of skill. This is all over him. They'll hear the bell. All up against Lenz again. Lenz isn't going to rush to make a rash decision again, or he won't see the second half. I think Roy's kick will probably be the last of the game. Or not. Oops. There we go. There's the halftime whistle. The halftime scores. Oh, Arsenal playing City. Early. He's seen. Good to see an early match between my two of my main title rivals. Chelsea are playing Spurs as well, so that's good. Hopefully both those matches will see those four teams all drop points. Be lovely if they all drew. Be fantastic. They all drop 2 points. Fantastic. Will that happen? Probably not, but you know, I can dream. And how did Sturridge miss that? It was actually harder to miss, Daniel. Rodwell is a sis. I can't pronounce that guy's name. I'm very sorry. He tried to play through. Rodwell was asleep. Klein is this. Here's Rodriguez. Over the top for Royce. Can he get there? Can he keep it in? I didn't keep it in. Larson's going to throw it straight to Maras. Nope. Royce. To Bale. Over the top to Sturridge. It's the control. Oh. Oh, I was hoping they were expecting. I thought they were expecting the pass. I'd be like, they will. They're expecting me to pass. DA. They outsmarted me. I'll give it that. Sturridge, can you get there first? Klein. Oh, Mignone was off position. I think it hit Lenz. Yeah, it did. If Lenz isn't there, that could be in the back of the net. 2-0. No, and I'm looking forward to the Norwich game. 6 points from 2 games. But Rafael Varane. And it's giving him the goal. Oh, it's 2-0 in the event. Not sure. The shot from Correa. Not sure where it hit Varane. I don't think it did. I'm pretty sure Varane is stealing his goal. It's giving it to him. Restarting at 2-0. It must have hit him. It didn't look like it did. In any event, it's 2-0. It doesn't matter who scored it, whether it's Correa's goal or not. I'm sure Correa would have something to say about that. And I'm sure he thinks it was his goal. I'm sure he would bank on it being his goal. Oh, but no, it's not his goal. It's been given as Varane's. There's not exactly anything he can do about that. And that's a free kick. Thank you very much. Was that Lenz again? It was as well. Wait, what? I fouled him. didn't foul him. He knocked Coutinho off out of the air. How is that his foul? Oh, Lens got away with that one. Not only was the foul not given against him, he got fouled, apparently. I'm not sure how that happened. That should have been him getting his final warning. No, yellow card if hinting in. No matter who your referee is. But definitely he should have gotten a warning. And look at this. Now he's plowed over Klein. Surely that'll get him a talking to. No? Here's Sturridge. Lawson is all over me. Can somebody give me help here? Go. Yes, go. Lens. Uh-oh. Laporte. Hey. He didn't even touch it, but he dealt with it. Because he prevented the Sunderland player from getting his shot away on goal as well. Also, very well done there by the Frenchman. Maras. Looking for Kabul, who is up here for some reason. You know it's he should be back here. This is the exact same thing Kabul did against us last year. In the first season, he went and up in search of glory, and he's got it. Yunus Kabul. It was a defender last season, and it's a defender this season. Yo, defenders are overpowered than the fucking strikers of my opposition teams. It took two games for me to concede my first goal this season. Fuck's sake. It doesn't matter. I'm beating them anyway. It was a consolation for Kabul. Very disappointing consolation. Can't believe that fucking happened. And to make matters worse, Chelsea won. Of course they did. Anyway, the upside is that they didn't win their first game. Oh, thank goodness, some good news. Tataxio will finally be off the books. He's not grown as would have liked. And better off to get him off the wage bill. Well, can get him off that wage bill and focus on some of the younger players like I am here with Costa. Costa's almost the same rating as frickin' Taxi. Or at a much younger age. So there's that. Spurs will come back with the same offer. I told you, 10.5 million. At least give me his valuation, Spurs. You can't spare an extra million. And you greedy dicks. 91, not bad. 84, not good enough. 87, Brito. Interesting name. Marvelous, hello. 94. You could get straight. You're probably going to get called straight up, hello. 88, yes. Thank you. 93. So it's going to be a left, middle or left back. Or centre back? Right. 6 foot? Would be an all right centre back. Perhaps I've accidentally found a new Roberto Carlos. Who knows? I know the chances are rather slim. I need to look at the, what's his name? Is this the guy? I know he's 17. So it's one of these guys. It's you. It's this guy. He's 54 already. Left mid 100%. I think I've found... You're probably all going to say he hasn't even flourished himself. But, yo, this guy's the new Neymar. I have found the new Neymar before Neymar has even become a player. He's already worthy of having people being called the next him. Isn't he? And look at Brito. 60 rated he's going to be. He offered that man a contract as well. 50, 51, 52. 50, 62? Oh, that's the goalkeeper. I'm the reason he's 62. 48. A right back? Next Danny Alves? Cheeky. Maybe he is. Who knows? Where's the guy who could play left back? Oh, he is a centre back. No, wait, that's not him. He was 6 foot. Oh, it's you. He is a left back. Is he the new Roberto Carlos? No, it's 51. Actually, I think he's 50. That was somebody else I was looking at. Yeah, 50. Put him through some training before I call him up. But yeah, nice cheeky few youngsters. Not a bad day in the youth player count. Two really good, promising young players for the future of this club. Yo, Spurs, if you're not going to pay the $10.5 million, fuck off. Okay? Hey? Because I'm not going to take... 9.5. Let's go a bit classical. This match. Go with one of the historic kits that you can get in the catalog. Of course, I got the Liverpool ones because, you know, why wouldn't I? At least this way, you were not looking at that standard shot of crap for the whole game. It looks much better blank. There's no numbers or names on the back, which is that's going to be a problem. Well, not really, because I have that thing where the players' names show up whenever they touch the ball. Also, it's not going to really affect them. I mean, we know. Plus, you can tell the player is a part without the names. Even without the name, you might know. No, this is Nathaniel Clyne. That's Daniel Sturridge. And that's 1-0. Oh. Different kit, same result. Sturridge with his second goal of the season. Already tied with Correa. A bit early to start feuding over top goal scorer ranks. Especially when already one of my defenders have scored a goal. Whether it was stolen from Correa or not. Still, I'm gonna be thinking about that for the rest of the day. I just know it. I just don't see how that was given as Varane's goal. I just don't. I didn't see it touch him. It must have, because it gave it as his goal. Probably like, you said it didn't fucking matter, and it doesn't. It doesn't. It doesn't matter. But still, you know, I would like to know how they gave it as Varane's goal. I'm sure he doesn't give a shit. Yeah, this one was all about power. It was all about the fact that he's hit it first time. That was enough. Probably thinking too much into it. Now they've got a free kick here. Sturridge. Correa. Correa. Continue. And Royce, 2 goals in 2 games for the German. He ran off, then decided to come back and give Coutinho a hug. That's nice. It's good to know Coutinho isn't salty about the that demolition of Brazil. Although, considering that, he wasn't there, so. Can't be salty about something you weren't part of. Redmond. Like, throw him to Liverpool. I'm sure Coutinho's thought process is, hey, I wasn't on that team, so I didn't get beaten by that embarrassing scoreline. I mean, haha. Suck that. Haters. Haters gotta hate, but you know, the lineup speaks for itself. Do you see my name in there? Yeah, nope. Didn't think so. Seeing that probably made Coutinho glad he didn't get called up. I'm sorry. Rubbing salt in the wound. Especially when I just picked up 2 really young Brazilians who if they are real people, who will have watched that and been like, don't really want to be a footballer anymore. I kid. It's just an easy target, isn't it? Turns. Got his shot off now. Got in and blocked it. And now a throw in. Wait, what? How was that his throw? Now that their throw. But the first one wasn't. Last one was cleared by the defender. It didn't touch a soul. Ooh. Don't even try and tell me that it bailed, because it didn't. Game is inventing ghost touches in these last 2 matches. Varane in the last match, and apparently Bale in this one. Not sure who Vale is. I think I'm watching too much Game of Thrones. Probably a good thing. I'm more caught up. I have to think about that until season 6 comes out. Did I see Arsenal are playing Manchester United? At Anfield, the second half is now underway. And it looked like it was 0-0. That's enough thinking about Arsenal and Manchester United. Focus on getting this 3rd goal against Norwich. If they get the ball off them first. How did Henderson? Very well done. Rodriguez. Back to Rodriguez. Yep. Continue. How well did he do for you in that first half? You bet Royce is a player to watch. He's already scored. It was a good goal from him. Good whip it in, looking for Sturridge. Turner got there first. Sturridge was miles away. Not sure why I was aiming for Sturridge when he was miles away. Come to the port, AC, is he gonna score? Sturridge, I'm jumping way too early. Way, hit the ref! Bell, Sturridge, looking for Correa. Whitaker gets it away. Rodriguez will header it back. Here's the Lois. It is Marco. Marco Lois. Up against Turner. What's Turner gonna do? Beating Turner. Henderson. Oh, Henderson scored a few of those last season. Not off the mark yet. This season. I didn't expect him to get one or two considering his goal scoring tally from last season. Nathaniel Klein, what in the name of God were you doing there? Nathaniel. Correa. It was after Coutinho. Somehow didn't go in. It's coming to Correa. Foul? Are you actually pulling the leg? What the hell? How is that not a foul on Correa? Oh, if they score from this, I'd be so pissed. Safely in my keeper's hands. You are so lucky, game. Here's careful. He can't pick that up, can he? That doesn't count as a back pass. Bullshit. Is there even a back pass foul in this game? I don't think I've ever seen, you know, that free kick in the box ever given in FIFA. Penalty. Come on, he practically rugby tackled Bale to the ground. Oh yeah, of course, that's a foul. Fuck you. Who in the ass, referee? You dumb shithead. No fouls. Who's when it's my player? Those who are on the floor, but when it's their players. Oh yeah, foul. Oh, every day of the week. Bias, dopey cunt. Doesn't matter. It's going to be the same result as against Sunderland. Well, not the same result. Not going to concede another late goal. In fact, I'm going to add to it. Coutinho, 3-0. What? I'm sorry. That's 3 from 3. Despite having the world's most biased referee. Slots it home. Coutinho with his first goal of the season. Very well timed, Philippe. Very well timed. Yeah, Norwich don't even get a chance to reply because their reply would have been rubbish. And way, United and Arsenal have both dropped 2 points. That's fantastic. So, who are my nearest rivals? I'm not even trying to be funny. I don't know what the table looks like. So let's remedy that, shall we? Shield. United are second, still with 7 points, but have already He lost 2 points on me. But they are yet to concede a goal. Arsenal fought less. Wow. Look away if you're a Geordie. Newcastle are bottom. Wow, it's a United. It's almost a full United down there in the relegation zone. Only Watford are like the odd team out, because West Ham United are third last. It's a very I mean, you know, if Watford got relegated this season, no one would be truly shocked. Newcastle are starting to turn it around. Arsenal are definitely not going to get fucking relegated. It's Chelsea who are in real life even threat. Speaking of Chelsea, they're 8. City 4th. United 2nd. But, as I already said, I already have a gap on Manchester United, and it's only going to get bigger. Especially if I keep winning. That's the main priority. Start training these boys straight away. Glitto. You're a guy. I'm gonna have to learn these guys' names. Rated goalkeeper, he'll go up to 63, no problem. Beat your man. Vera. Gonna be all the youngsters, really. All the youth. They should all go up at least one, hopefully. No? Only one of you went up. You all are terrible people. Come on, Miller. As you were so close, how did you not go up? Why do I get the feeling this will be a long, long row? Hope to get these guys up as I'd hope. Well, at least the goalkeeper guy went up. Way! There's a somber note. Good. Spurs have agreed to stop up wasting my time and theirs and just pay the fucking cash for Joe Allen. So, in the next episode, I will have the first cup game of the season against Notts County and the A League game against West Bromwich Albion. So you're going to see the second team in the first match of the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy.